Well, we met when Anna's sister Ashley introduced us. We worked at CDW together, Ashley and I, and just came over to her house one Friday night for a party, and I walked into their living room, and Anna and I's eyes just locked. And literally the whole room faded to black, and all I saw was her eyes. She never ceases to amaze me. I personally do everything I can every day to make sure that she still loves me and that I earn her love every day.
We were married August 1st, 2009, and we were at the Hyatt Regency in Deerfield, Illinois, and it was the best day of my life. Everyone there really just believed in us and believed in our relationship, and that was the most important thing to us, is that we had everyone around us that loved us. And
obviously I was, you know, very excited to marry Anna. It was the best day of my life, and it went off without a hitch. Everything was perfect. The ceremony was fantastic, just because it went from gray skies, questionable weather, to just sunshine as soon as Anna literally made her way down the aisle. And I just, you know, my whole thing when I was standing up there was to make sure my knees didn't lock so I wouldn't pass out or anything, just to keep calm, and just seeing her come out was just the most beautiful sight I've ever seen. We had all of our friends and family there to watch over us and give us their blessing, and everybody said they felt a lot of love, you know, in the room as well as in the courtyard where we got married. And once we took the party inside, it was without a hitch the whole night. Everybody had a great time.
I found out I was pregnant. It was November 22nd, and I took a pregnancy test. We were obviously trying. And I remember like waiting, and I peeked over by the sink, and it said pregnant, and I was like, wow, my life's gonna change dramatically. Thankful enough, we got pregnant our first try. I waited till before Christmas. I put the pregnancy test in a present by the tree.
Yeah, I opened up the present. I don't remember what it was. It was just a box, I think, just a little tube. And I dug down over the tinsel or whatever, and I saw the onesie. And I think there was a pacifier in there. And I remember all I said was, oh my God, oh my God, oh my God. We just held each other and hugged and kissed, and just right before Christmas, that I found out, so it was the best Christmas gift I've ever gotten.
I felt great the whole time. I mean, a year before we got pregnant, I just made sure I ate really clean and just, you know, prepared myself. Strauss Killage Rassum, born on August 25th, 2011. He weighed 6 pounds, 9 ounces.
We had plenty of friends and family. We had about 12, mostly family members, in the delivery room with us. We were at Evanston Hospital, and the whole day from pretty much noon till 10:32 p.m. for that 10 and a half hours, and the doctors all came in, and all the nurses came in, the bed got taken apart, and it got real, real fast. And Anna stuck to her guns with not wanting any kind of drugs or medication. I knew she was a strong girl when I met her, and that's why I married her. And she definitely proved herself a 1,000 times over when she delivered our son naturally.
He is the best, baby. No, he's very, he's all boy. And just grunts and just makes all sorts of noises. He's we just got his sleeping down, and he's just a really good baby. From the moment he came home, he just fit in very well, and
we always say he's a harsh dude. He definitely lets you know what he wants when he wants it. He's got very loving eyes, very sweet personality, but he will let you know when he's hungry or tired or fussy. I love watching him do his actions, because I always said I think he's gonna look like Anna and act like me, and that's exactly what it is so far. I get a kick out of watching him do anything from yawning to stretching. We came up with Strauss a year into us dating. We both wanted a strong name. We want something that's different, that we haven't heard before as a first name. It's a German surname that means fight, so But there was a lot of fight in both of us, and it pretty much fit us to have a son whose first name means fight as well.
Things have changed for the better. It just feels more complete. It feels like he's always, you know, always been here, and
he's been the best baby, and it's been more of us learning how to realize what his cries mean and what he wants and what he needs at different times. We couldn't ask for anything more in our baby boy.
If I can wish Strauss anything, it would be a lifetime of health and just happiness. And I always want him to be happy.
The few key factors you need in order to be successful are just to, number one, take care of your health. Everything else falls into place as long as you're healthy. And then from then on, just not be scared of anything and be a hardworking, strong, honest, respectful individual, and everything else will come to you.
If there's anything left here, we should be waiting for.